everyone, and welcome back to a brand new episode of Attack on Show. I'm Robbie.
And I'm Jay Marsh.
It's the show that's got you covered on all formats for your viewing pleasure.
All of them.
TV, streaming services, DVDs, movies, and the theater. We've got you covered when you don't know what to watch.
Even the interwebs.
Yes, wherever that is. Check out Attack on Show. We will narrow down the selections for you so you're not wasting time, and we will help you find what's good for you to watch. On today's exciting episode, we're taking a look at the Frozen follow-up and preview review with Elsa.
Yes, wow, Disney's going to probably hit another home run with this.
This has to be this is going to be a winner. And then on BCon Rewind, one of my personal faves, Hot Fuzz.
Yes, and a phenomenal movie.
Super excited about this.
And thus then, the Scottish shirt.
Is it Scottish?
Yeah, it is.
Oh, nice. I'm always afraid to look below the table.
Yeah.
And then on Bingeworthy, we're going to go over to Amazon Prime streaming service for one of their originals. Always just Netflix.
No, it's not. No, most of the time, or Hulu. But yes.
We're taking a look at Jack Ryan.
Yeah, phenomenal.
A lot of hype around this show. If you haven't seen it by now, what's wrong with you?
Right,
but hey, we're here to cover you. And then on I Miss My MTV, as we always do, got to close it out with a song.
Yeah.
We have a very cool live performance from Manchester Orchestra.
Which is just, if you've not seen this, you got to take the opportunity to see
this guy's voice is amazing. But don't click the link yet.
Yeah.
Before you click that link, click subscribe.
Like.
And the bell.
The bell. Because what happens, Rob, if we don't click the bell?
If you don't click the bell, you're going to miss episodes. If you do click the bell, you're not going to miss episodes. Simple as that.
It's that simple,
Rob. Very easy fix,
people. It is. It's incredibly
easy fix.
Click
the bell. Everybody, this is
Attack on Show.
All right, as we stated in the introduction, we've got a fabulous preview for preview review.
We do.
This is the Frozen follow-up?
Yes, it is.
Elsa, take a look. We're sure this is Disney?
Yeah, no, it is. Rob, trust me. Let's be honest, that music only means one thing.
You're eating it?
Yeah, no, absolutely. Yeah, I'm ordered out for Chinese. Yeah.
Ninja Dust!
Hello?
It was definitely the UPS guy, because you ever know how many knocks and then you just walk out and say,
who was it?
Just the wind.
When does the wind ever knock?
Like, does he pull that off at other times? Yeah, like when she wakes up sore, like, what happened last night? It was the wind.
It was the wind. Hey, oh. do you want to build a snowman?
Ha ha, real funny, guys. So funny.
Oh, they spared no expense on the special effects. Not Arthur Vanderhey, you know what I'm talking about.
She won't let us leave.
That wind knocking is very annoying.
What's going on? Come on, Disney! You can do better than this.
So
wow.
Apparently buying Disney. Fox turned Disney a little dark.
Yeah. Wow, that or just ran out of money. Wow.
I'm a little disturbed.
Is
nothing sacred anymore?
Nothing, really. Like, wow. And you know what? The whole thing and not a single you want to build a snowman joke.
No.
The kids are going to be a little disappointed in this.
I feel like that movie could have had some fun with that carrot.
Yeah. that was not a porn parody?
I thought it was going to go that way.
I thought it was too. That was really. I'm disappointed in two ways. I really am in this one.
So apparently, this Christmas, keep an eye out for Elsa. That was the official horror trailer. Link is below. Don't go just yet. Hold on. No. I know you guys are itching. Don't do it yet.
Yeah.
Want to go to Be Kind Rewind? We need to lighten the mood with some.
Let's go someplace, because that was that left me ready to go somewhere.
Okay, let it go. I'm super excited for this segment this week because we've covered Edgar Wright before.
Yes.
With Baby Driver.
Yes.
My fave. And this is a previous fave. Still a fave.
This is a classic.
Yeah.
I don't think you can say fave.
2007 is not classic.
Yeah, it is. That's over 10 years ago.
We're better than this, Jeff. We're here looking at 2007's Edgar Wright's Hot Fuzz.
That's what I'm talking about.
And this is a great movie. It stars Simon Pegg and Nick Frost, who worked with
Simon Pegg of Star Wars fame?
Sorry. Before Star Wars. They did get to work with Edgar Wright and Shaun of the Dead. This group of people have always worked together, and it's great to see them continuously do movies together. I always look for the Edgar Wright, Nick Frost, Simon Pegg team-ups whenever movies come out. This movie, Hot Fuzz, is a fantastic film in the idea that it covers every single genre that is out there.
It's got
horror in it. Yes. It's got comedy in it. It's got great action sequences in it.
Phenomenal action sequences.
It's a very well done, all put together film that is, it's well edited. It's got the Edgar Wright touch of how he edits, the quick pacing edits.
Super cop, meet the cop that can't be stopped.
It's a great film, and the premise of the movie is basically it takes place in London, and Simon Pegg is like this overachieving officer.
Wow, interesting.
Yeah, we need to have some more.
Yeah.
And basically he gets reassigned to like a small town where nothing happens. And he's frustrated by this, and he goes there, and of course he's by the book trying to basically arrest everybody, and then he gets partnered with Nick Frost. Who is just this
phenomenal,
amazing, well played by him. Just this like goof of an officer who just, you know, he's there for the paycheck. His dad is the police chief. He's had a free ride his whole life. He is excited to meet Simon Pegg's character because he's loved movies like Point Blank and, you know, Bad Boys. And basically, you know, just starts like hammering Simon Pegg on, you know, have you ever...
Ever fired two guns whilst jumping through the air?
No.
You ever fired one gun whilst jumping through the air?
No.
It's fantastic the way, you know, his idea of what Simon Pegg is in this movie. And there's some really great chemistry between the two.
And it's one of those movies that is great. You can notice there's a lot of ad-libbing going on.
Oh, like,
there's
just it has kind to of be.
Just a phenomenal, yeah.
Unlike this show, they got the ad-lib a little bit.
Yeah, yeah.
We're 100% prepared.
completely by the book. Yes.
Timothy Dalton has a great role in this movie where he owns like a the store in town, which is like the Walmart in town, and it's a great film that, again, we've mentioned this in other movies that we covered, that you will take one-liners from it. And you will say these lines somewhere else. You know, there's a great line Nick Frost says that I was at the gun range talking to a guy, and basically, you know, Nick Frost says the line.
Is it true that there is a place in a man's head that if you shoot it, it will blow up?
And he's like an officer asking this question dead serious.
Yes, yeah.
And it's just great to like take those, you know, you take that and ask a complete stranger and they look at you like you're nuts.
That's, yes.
You get the joke, you know, it's all in good fun. The movie is full of those lines where you will just find yourself for days thinking, recalling these lines and just kind of laughing at it. It's very creative.
No.
I suppose.
Yes, I suppose. Thank you.
This is definitely a movie that if you're lost in a night not knowing what you want to watch and you just can't quite pick, you know, you want something funny, you want some, you know, you can't quite narrow down what you're in the mood for.
This is one of those
throw it on, something
absolutely.
For you.
It's a really good time. My teenage boys enjoy this movie.
Oh,
it's a lot.
It's
fun.
A movie of all ages. Yes. You know, there's some violence, there's some blood, but there's no nudity. There's a little bit of language, but I would say like a young teenager or even, you know, down to 11 and up if your 11 year old's a little more mature.
Or would a be 7 year old if you've met my 7 year old.
You know, it's got some gore to it, but that's as far as they take it.
It is,
and
yes.
Again, the effects in this movie are amazing.
Yeah,
it's one
really
of those
are.
Things
yeah.
that.
Well, you know, I often say that it's well filmed. In that point, yes,
it's well filmed. It's everything in this movie is well pulled off. Like I said, I mean, Simon Pegg, he's generally just a comedic actor, and same with Nick Frost. But the way that they film this movie and the way that they cut and edit the action sequences, they make Simon Pegg a badass.
They do. They truly do. Yes.
You're afraid
yes.
of the guy in yes. this movie, but yet he's, you know, he's what? He's a small guy.
Yes.
He, you know, in all of his other movies, he's always like a slough that doesn't do anything just except drink and beer. But in this movie, they made him a badass.
They did.
And it's great.
Well, it fits so well.
Yes. It just, they do a great job of pulling all the parts together in this movie that you'll be grinning through most of it. You'll be scared through
part of it.
Oh,
you'll laugh. You'll laugh. Yeah. You won't even be grinning. This has got some solid laughs in it. Yes.
You'll be scared because you don't quite know what's happening. There's something for everybody in this movie, and I highly recommend.
Please.
Check out Hot Fuzz. It is on Netflix. It's worth clicking on.
Got a mustache. I know.
So definitely check out Hot Fuzz.
Hot Fuzz, absolutely.
I would definitely rewind and click on Netflix to watch this movie. Yeah?
Yeah, no, absolutely.
Fun movie.
Yeah.
Do you want to go to some binge-worthy?
Yeah, binge-worthy!
Listen up now. This is serious.
I was just wondering,
No!
All right, it's time for binge-worthy. And so we're not sued for false advertising. We are going to prove to you that we do have other streaming services other than Netflix. We're looking at...
Oh, we do?
Yeah.
Yeah, well, they're not paying us either. So
we are going to look at Amazon Prime's original series, Jack Ryan.
I would say the streaming service that everyone has,
you already
and
have
everyone
it.
Forgets.
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah, you're already paying for the two-day shipping. You might as well watch some free programming.
Yes.
Jack Ryan stars John Krasinski, who is amazing in the role as, I believe it's Jack Ryan, does he play?
Yes, he does. Okay. Incredible.
Does a great job playing Jack Ryan, who's a CIA, basically, intelligence officer.
If you're kind of familiar with the Jack Ryan character, you know, not to give too much away, but if you get the opportunity...
Previously played by Harrison Ford.
Yes, and actually becomes president.
Ben Affleck, too. I got to plug Ben Affleck.
Yeah. Oh, we did. Who played Jack Ryan? Do you remember in Hunt for Red October?
It was one of the bald ones.
It was one of the bald ones. One of them, it doesn't matter. So.
They all look the same.
They do.
It's only 8 episodes long, so it is a very short season.
It is.
There are our episodes, but it's a great cast. Abby Cornish is on it, who is a Sucker Punch alum.
Amazon did a really good job with that.
Yes, yeah. Amazon Prime did a great job. Wendell Pierce, who has popped up on Suits, he does a great supporting role. He's basically Jack Ryan's partner throughout the film, the series. I say film because obviously when you're watching this series,
it feels that way. It does very much feel that way. Rob is absolutely right. It does feel like a film.
Amazon spared no expense when it came to the series. I mean, it is filmed on
Jurassic
location.
Park reference.
Yeah. They didn't consider whether or not they should.
They. Well done.
I forget the rest of the line.
I know.
Too many.
That's right.
But it is very film-esque when you're watching the series. It's the locations are on point. The camera angles, the explosions, the effects. It's not just cheesy computer animation.
No, it's
you can
really
tell
not.
That they did some real-life explosions. They did some real carnage sets that they were actually running through instead of just trying to do some of the after effects.
Which is probably more than likely why it went 5 episodes for the first season.
8.
8, sorry. Yes. Numbers are hard.
But they did say, season 1 is like a half season. So they are going to release more episodes, obviously, but they're not actually calling it a season 2. It's almost like they're releasing a second half of season 1. But the series is great. If you didn't watch any of the previous movies like Clear and Present Danger, it basically follows Jack Ryan, who's ex-military.
Actually, this sticks much closer to the books, if you've read the books.
Yeah, he's a CIA agent. He's just basically at a desk. He's like an intelligence agent and basically finds a case that pulls him back into the field.
Correct.
He's got some military experience, but he doesn't want to go back to that. He's kind of basically fighting the idea of having to get back into the field. He doesn't want that lifestyle back. But the show does a great job of bouncing him back and forth, of putting him in the field, bringing him back in the office. And it really puts things in perspective when you meet people that do this for a job and they can't really talk about what they do. They don't go so far-fetched action that, he's a superhero.
Correct.
I love the idea
done.
That the series kept
absolutely.
It very realistic.
Yes.
He gets beat up. When he gets shot, it hurts. It takes him out of the fight.
Yes.
So the show does a great job of keeping a realistic approach on it. And it is a great series that I don't think suffers from the streaming service originals that they can kind of take a break because they know you'll just go to the next episode. If this were a series that were on weekly, I would be hooked. I would be excited to wait for the next week's episode, and I would be there watching it live.
Yeah, and eight is short. Each one is great. It is a short season. I mean, you're talking 8 hours of. It's actually a very short season.
It is when in comparison. So definitely, if you've already paid for the 2-day, you know, delivery service, I highly recommend.
All of you have it. You don't realize it, but everyone has Amazon
you do.
Prime.
Yes. Go over to the Amazon Prime streaming service and definitely check out Jack Ryan starring Absolutely. John Krasinski. You won't be disappointed. And then leave comments below. Let us know if you watched it, if you liked it. And then tag John Krasinski on Twitter saying,
and
hey,
let him know.
Attack on Show told me to watch your show and I loved it. So go and thank Attack on Show.
Even if you didn't like it, can you please say that to
him? Even if you don't watch it, just do that right now.
Yeah, please, please.
Okay,
so
it's very easy.
Well, with that being said and talking about getting to the end, I'm pretty low, Rob. Are you ready?
I can catch up. What's next?
Are you ready for it?
For?
Free MTV.
Oh, I do miss my MTV. All right, it is time for I Miss My MTV, my favorite part. And Jeff had a say in this.
I did this week.
He
did. Yeah, absolutely.
I played a few tracks. He picked this one. This week, we're going to bring you Manchester Orchestra, which has been a longtime favorite of mine.
And I absolutely love this
right
now. Yes,
a very unique voice from the lead singer here. This is actually a live performance of a song called The Silence. When you do click the link below to finish the track, just know that there is a long intro because they did, you know, like a live recording of this. So let it play out. It's actually an 8-minute and 45-second track.
Which is super long.
Yes,
absolutely.
Which is longer than anyone ever sticks to our show. So I doubt you're
True. Yeah.
not
going to
be a problem because you're not even watching this.
No one's here.
If you do watch track, click first below. And then also go to Manchester Orchestra's
I let them know
video,
we sent you.
Say, Attack on Show brought us here. You need to thank them. So Manchester Orchestra reaches out to us. We get them on the show for a live
Cheers.
Performance. We
yes.
sign a TV deal. It all goes from there thanks to you. So check it out. This is Manchester Orchestra.
The big plan?
Oh yeah, of course. We're gonna make it.
All right.
So Manchester Orchestra, amazing band out of Atlanta, Georgia.
Absolutely.
A great sound to them.
Yes. They use the term orchestra, and it's a big band, and you don't get that very often. I've often referred to the return of rock, and you're kind of seeing that gearing up. And this is definitely someone I could see leading
big
that
band,
charge.
Great unique vocals, definitely worth checking out. And if you like that track, they have a lot of great music in their library that I think you'll really enjoy. So when you click that link to finish that track, because like I said, it's an 8.5-minute track, make sure you let them know Attack on Show brought you there. You know, that again, that's how we're going to make it.
Absolutely.
And then we appreciate you guys watching. Hopefully you've made it this far. It's been fun.
It has.
We hope that you'll continue watching because we enjoy what we're doing.
And yeah, we do.
We're going to keep this going, whether you like it or not.
Man, so, we're going to be here.
Yeah, the thumbs down, we're taking Ed as thumbs up.
Yes, yeah, yeah. Anything you put in there, we're going to take.
Yeah, so if you're putting a lot of thumbs up, that's going to hurt our feelings. So just go ahead and click that then if you really want to make
us mad. Yeah, really make us angry.
All right, thank you for watching. We're continuing to be here next week. Tell your friends, share it on Facebook, Instagram, LinkedIn, Snapchat, LinkedIn. Anything else out there?
I don't know. There's some other stuff, I'm sure.
Whatever you're hip to, share it on that. So, everybody, I'm Robbie.
And I'm Jay Marsh.
This is
Attack On Show.